Hello everyone, and welcome back to my Norman Invasion campaign. Alas, I won't be doing this one in an English accent, because if I did the rest of the campaign like this, I would lose my mind, I'm sure. And when we last left off, we were on the precipice of taking two towns, so that's what I'll show you in this session. In addition, we need to strengthen our hold here in the lands, English lands that we've taken. So my priority now, since I am making a profit, a tidy little profit here, not counting the construction of recruitment I've already done, I really want to focus on garrisoning what I have here properly. I'll build a Norman Cider Hall that will allow me to recruit Axemen as well, which will be handy against an armored unit such as House Carls. They don't die in droves as it is. And now here, I want to build myself a Norman mustard field, and that cost me, where's the price, oh, 640, so we're still making plenty of money. Guildford, I think it should be the same thing, yes. Mustard field, yes, where they grow mustard. Mustard field. I already have one here, which is good. So let's see here. Since we can't do anything else, once again, we really want to focus on recruitment. So let's go north then to Hartford, another muster field, and in Bedenford, I think. That obviously needs local lordship first, before anything else happens. Now I think I've built in. My goodness, I'm really winning today, aren't I? There we go. One final mustard field here. Now, I still have some money left, so let's go to the territories that don't have any. For example, this boat will really help trade and give me an extra 100 gold a turn, so let's do that. Anything else? Anything else on the mainland? No. I'm afraid not. Which is fine. So let's look at our beloved Norman, the 1,000 or so. Boulogne, oh my, doesn't even have roads. That costs quite a bit right now. Let's build ourselves something to Norman butts. Oh, funny. What can we do to increase our wealth that's relatively inexpensive? Nothing really. Okay, well let's look at what else we have here. Rouen? No, I'm gonna either have to spend money or save money. Let's spend a little bit of money. Boulogne needs roads. There's no question. You can't get far without roads. So, there we go. Alright, so we have our first battle here, outside the capital. Looks like some Ferdmen and some Lightford and some peasants have come to assist the beleaguered forces inside, and I have Henri de Farrar plus his forces, as you can see right here, going to defend. It's 2-1 in my favor. I'll see you on the battle map. Okay, so I thought I'd just show you my setup here real quick. I have in my front line all my archers, my mercenary Bretons, and my regular Norman trained archers. In addition, in my second line, I have a spearman, obviously, to accept any sort of charge that's going to come their way. Plus some axemen heavy on the right to kind of do a striking movement. In addition, I have my cavalry on the left to also act as strikers. Then I finally have a reserve line of my monks, and then of course my armored spearmen. And then finally my general in the center. Now the enemy has set up here a little bit, as we can see. This is the force that attacked me, and the force that's coming from inside the castle is coming up behind me. So I'm going to actually have to change my formation because I'm not facing a single unified force, so I'll get back to you in a moment. Alright, so I've split my forces up in two. My first group is right here with mostly archers and spearmen because I feel like I can handle these Ferdmen. like so. So they're going to rain a little bit of death on there, and then I have my other opposing forces, with my more harder units, trying to take care of this, the forces from inside here, because I think there are house guards, but maybe not. No, there are not, so this is going to be a pretty quick and bloody battle. But, let's take a look, shall we? Don't think I'll need to pause very much in this. Great, so I'm already raining arrows down upon these fellows, which is good. Let's hit their light infantry first. There we are. Looks like they're staying up there. Peasants are pretty much destroyed, which makes sense. Alright, so now they're coming to face me. So now they do have light javelins that they do like to hurl. So what I'm going to do is actually bring up my line here to face them as quickly as possible. There we go. And we're going to start to circle these guys around on their right, I think. Yes. And we're going to just kind of split these guys up a little bit. They're skirmishing, but I want to make sure they don't get stuck in the fight, like so. Now where's the other force? Nah, it's not coming yet. Perfect. Keep an eye out on this. Oh no, looks like they're not ready to hurl their weapons just yet, so we might as well just have these guys stop, have these guys get ready to flank right over there. Very good. And now, my men should have somewhat of a flanking position. Yes, they do. Oh, and now I think they're ready to hurl. Yeah, looks like they are going to, so let's charge in then. And have these guys attack the back ranks. Move my axemen up. Very good. Yeah, sure enough, there goes there. So I did take a healthy chunk of casualties, but that's okay. Now, I am going to... There we are. Oh dear. Ah, I forgot how crappy these spearmen are. Okie doke. Let's send in my... Where's the other guys? God. Darn you, spearmen. Okay, let's bring in my cavalry then. They're mobile enough. They'll be able to assist. Okay, and my archers, I think, are going to stop firing now and start maneuvering again to the rear of the line, like so. There we go. Alright. I should have these opposing... these men shot here, because I'm not impressed with their lack of resolve. There we go. Now we'll do a nice little flanking attack. My light infantry is going to clean up their routing units. Here comes my own pretty soon. Now, I could fire into them, but I don't think I'm going to. Instead, I think I'm going to charge my cavalry into that open flank. I really do want to limit my casualties. I've gotten to the point of this war where, let's see here. How are they doing here? Just fine. Good. In fact, actually, my archers no longer play a part. So, let's see if we can't run at least this flank up. See if they can actually participate. Why not these guys too? Anyway, as I was saying, I've gotten to the part of my war where I don't want to get in too much of a battle of attrition because they still have a lot more territories than I do. No, although their troops are weaker, they might start outnumbering me. So we have to kind of limit my casualties as much as possible, especially if my good units. Little guys like this, they can be retrained. There we go. So, let's just have my cavalry once again pursue. The rest of these guys can move up with... Oh, no. There we go. Got a new group key. Move up here. Perfect. Alright. So now we have battle... mini battle number two. And, yeah, so these guys are being pursued. How am I, light cab, doing? Did they get too far out of the battle? Let's see.
Light cavalry.
You're chasing three guys. No, you know what? Screw it. Let's kill them. Forget it. Go for it, boys. There we go. Alright. Ah, I forgot how quickly my archers move. That's good to see. Okay, so now my light infantry is done. Oh, no, they're not quite done. They're still pursuing. I think these guys are done now. I think they're done cleaning up all the English scum. Yeah, they are. Good. Alright, just in time for them to run up to here. Ah. Let's see. Little archers. There we go. Ah, excellent. They can all fire. Oh, my cavalry's run down their one leader. Very good. Now, it looks like they're moving upon my left flank. So, let's move up my infantry along here. We'll have them move. Run, run, run. Very good. And actually, we'll have these guys move as well, so they don't accidentally shoot my men in the back. Oh, this cavalry's done, so they can start sliding back over here. I'll move these guys up a little bit. Leave my knights where they are. Oh, great, now they've come to face this line. Perfect. So we'll do something very similar. We're going to keep this weak unit here because it's not going to do us any good. Move them over to do a good little double envelopment, hopefully, will work. They're also exposing their backs, which is nice of them. Very, very generous of them to do so. Okay, there's a little danger moving my men through here, but that's okay. I think we're going to have my archers stop firing now. And I think we're going to charge in. Finish them off pretty quickly. Okay, do that. Do that. And you know what? Let's throw in my general, too. I think he'll want to be take a part of this. And my cav. Where's my light cav? Oh, over there. Perfect. So one big, giant charge. I'll give you a, I'll finally give you guys a close-up of this. So you can take a look at the doom that will be happening quite soon. There we are. How long do you think you would last if you were faced with this, Not very long, I think. There we go. So I'm going to just clean up these guys, and I'll get back to you at the results screen. Wonderful, so that was a clear victory with 802 kills, and it looks like a little under... 140 losses. Alright, I'll see you back out on the campaign map.